Is there an MSN sign-in for Hotmail? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. After all this time, it still amazes me how many people refer to Hotmail or MSN Hotmail or variations thereof. The fact is, those things have long since gone by the wayside. Yes, you may still have a hotmail.com email address, as I do, but you're not using Hotmail anymore, and MSN hasn't done email for years. So the real question is, what happened? How did we get here? I gotta tell you, it's a long and winding road over decades that has us where we are today. Now, to start, I want to be clear that it's almost an all-for-one and one-for-all kind of a scenario, or maybe all-for-one and all via one. What's happened is Microsoft has settled on Outlook.com as the interface for you to read and manage any Microsoft-provided email address. So if you have a Hotmail.com email address, go to Outlook.com to read your email. Similarly, if you have an @live.com or @outlook.com or @passport.com or @webtv.com or any number of different Microsoft-provided email accounts, you all go to Outlook.com to read your email. It's that simple. There is no MSN Hotmail or MSN sign-in for Hotmail. Although, if you go to Hotmail.com, you'll end up on Outlook.com. The bottom line here, though, is that it's all been funneled into Outlook.com. So, what happened? Years of what I will call marketing and strategy changing. Because, again, in reality, in the beginning, Microsoft purchased Hotmail back in 1997, over 25 years ago. Then they basically turned that into the MSN Hotmail that so many people remember. The reason they did that is that rather than having Hotmail as a standalone product, they wanted it to become a part of the MSN family of products. It's cross-marketing, it's strategy, it's I don't know what it is, but that's what they did back when MSN was a thing. If you remember, back at that time, MSN was actually a dial-up internet provider. Some of you may still have your Hotmail accounts or an MSN account from those days. But strategies change, especially over 25 years. In 2007, Hotmail was reintroduced, if you will, or rebranded as Windows Live Hotmail. That, as you might imagine, is a function of or a result of the strategy change that basically changed the focus from MSN to Windows Live. Rather than focusing on the old Microsoft network, they were focusing more of their energy on Windows itself. And Windows Live was a brand with, again, a family of products that they decided to incorporate part of Hotmail into. Now, in 2013, again, still over a decade ago, they introduced Outlook.com. Outlook.com, over the course of the next couple of years, basically replaced Hotmail.com or any of the other entry points as Microsoft's primary email interface. It's where Outlook.com accounts were created, but if you had a Hotmail account, it's where, again, you went to read your email. That was phased in. It sat side by side with Hotmail.com and others for some time, probably several years. But the bottom line is that today, if you have a Microsoft-supplied email account, be it free, which is most of us, or paid, which can still exist, Outlook.com online is your primary way of reading and managing your email. That's all that's happened. So the MSN sign-in for Hotmail is Outlook.com. The Hotmail sign-in for Hotmail is Outlook.com. The Windows Live sign-in for Hotmail is Outlook.com. I think you can see a trend. Just go visit Outlook.com, sign in with whatever email address and password you have, and you should be good to go. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/167961. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.